And you're not alone. You are loved. Mm-hmm. God loved us first.
Yes. Hallelujah. Hey guys, it's me, Tania. Thank you so much for clicking on today's video. You're not all the way in the frame.
Anyway,
I'm here with Reggie, and we are talking about the Lord and how spending time with the Lord by yourself, but in today's topic, specifically outside, is extremely healing and helpful. So, Reggie, you can start outside.
Yes, for me, I'm an outdoors person, for the most part. I love being outdoors. I'm a photographer also, so I like taking pictures of everything. For the most part, we're just talking about how good God's grace is. And how being outside, you can just see the glory and just see all the creation that the Creator made.
And like, I know for me, God can speak to each one of His children in different ways. And I know for me specifically, and I'm sorry y'all, if y'all hear anything in the background, we are at the art museum. They're having a little outside event. They playing drums. It's hitting, but you know, you might hear it in the video. Anyway, like I was saying, God talks to each one of His children in different ways. You know, obviously through His word, first and foremost, but you know, maybe through a rhema word where it's something specific to your situation. For me, He talks to me through nature a lot. That's just one of the ways He talks to me. And He's spoken to me through the clouds, through the sun, through the moon. And I know that might sound cheesy, but at the end of the day, for me, it's real. And I can feel in my spirit, you know, I think I made a video in the past where I said, listen to God with your spirit ear, like not try to listen to your natural ear because you're not going to be in tune to hear Him. He's a spirit. So at the end of the day, being outside for me is extremely peaceful. If you watched any of our previous videos, well, one of our recent videos when we were outside, we live in North Carolina, so it's not hard to find a place to spend time with God alone outside. But if you are not in the country or in a place outside where you can spend time with God alone, maybe even just take a walk outside.
You can see just natural creation. Natural creation will just put you in a worship mindset.
Yeah, it most definitely will, because we got so much going on every single day, you know. We have work. If you have children, you have to raise your children. There's just different stresses that will take your mind off of the Lord. And being outside in nature is going to help you be present-minded. And you will be able to hear the voice of God. Like, a lot of times, that's what He wants us to do, is just be by ourselves with Him. And if we're by ourselves with Him outside of the four walls, away from TV, away from your phone, and like actually laying eyes on His creation, that's when you are most open. Or not even if you're not alone, like sometimes we, you know, spend time with God together and you can just really feel His presence.
Two or three agree and meet. Who was in
the name of Jesus?
In the name of Jesus, He is in the midst.
Yes. So I just encourage you, if you are a person who is in God, but you just don't want to go outside, and I can understand not wanting to go outside. Some of us might be dealing with emotional issues and we just find it hard to even walk across a threshold. But even if it's just 5 minutes a day, just get outside the house and engage the Lord outside. Get some fresh air. Look at the sky. Be thankful that you've seen another day, because at the end of the day, God don't have to give us another day. Every morning His mercies are new, and each day that He gives us an opportunity to breathe and look outside and see the sky, that's a blessing, you know.
Even if you just walk outside in your neighborhood and just look up at the trees, or in your backyard and just stare off of your back deck or balcony, wherever, just see creation, like movement, clouds, bees, birds, all of that, like anything that you see that is life, like just know that the Lord made that.
And when you're outside, away from things, away from distractions, like I said before, that is one of the most opportune times to spend time with Him, to speak to Him, to hear His voice, to hear His plans for you. God is giving out instructions. He wants to tell you whatever you have questions about in your life. He wants to give you insight, spiritual, divine insight about what you should do in a situation. But if you're never separating yourself from people, going outside, engaging what he's created, then it's going to be hard for you to hear his voice. And you don't even have to go outside to hear God's voice, but it's just like, it makes it that much easier to lay eyes on what he's created to engage him, in my opinion.
Because you're out of your natural environment, like of in the house, in your room, or wherever that is, to where you can just have fresh air, you can breathe, you can just hear the wind
feel
blow.
Him breathe on you, like, you know what I'm saying? Just like feel everything. I don't mean to cut you off.
No, it's real. It's real.
I know for me, like, I sometimes will just look out the window, and then, you know, I'll go out in the backyard with my dog, just stand and look at the trees and look at the moon, and just feel in my spirit something that God has been trying to talk to me about. Or even in the clouds, like rainbows is another way that he speaks to me. I love whenever God shows me a rainbow. Like, there was one point I started a new journey earlier this year, and literally the same day God showed me a rainbow, and I felt in my spirit as if he's anointed that journey. Like, it's a good thing. He's pleased with that new journey that I decided to start. So, like, clouds, he's a photographer, as he mentioned, and he has so many pictures, a whole catalog of cloud pictures that, you know, if you're interested, you can check out his Instagram page. Just pay attention to God, not just what people are saying online, through sermons or through just videos like this. Go outside, engage him for yourself. Anything you hear in a sermon or even a video like this should be confirmation. And one of the easiest ways you can get confirmation of what God is telling you is through listening for his voice. And the easiest way to do that is when you get outside and disengage from the phones, from the TV, from people who are getting on your nerves inside your house, whatever, just get outside the house.
And meditate on the word. Meditate on a prayer, meditate on a scripture, and just sit there in there and just listen in silence, and just be in the moment and be present, because that's when he'll show up. He's always going to show up.
He will always show up.
But in that moment, when you really, like, disassociate from just regular everyday life and you just be there and just sit in the present right there, there's nothing like it. When it hits you, you know.
Yeah, if you are interested in, you know, us even talking about God together, let me know in the, you know, comment section below. I hope y'all were blessed by something that we said in this video. And until the next video, whether it be me by myself or us together, y'all be blessed.
And you're not alone. You are loved. God loved us first.
Yes. Hallelujah. Okay. See y'all later. Bye.